is misunderstood when we separate between reason and faith. When aql, reason, and faith, religion, are separated, then Islam is being misunderstood. How does that happen? Always reason moves in the same direction, hand in hand with faith. There is no clash between them. They are synonymous, actually. And they move parallel to each other. Aql and deen, parallel to each other. They support each other. They are in harmony with each other. There is no clash between a true religion and sound reason. If one day you find there is a clash between sound reason and religion, it means there is something wrong with that religion. Something wrong. That religion is not authentic. The authentic religion always moves parallel with sound intelligence, with sound reason. And this is in the Quran. And this is in the Hadith. لا دين لمن لا عقل له. There is no faith for someone who does not have reason. Because once he loses his reason, immediately it means he lost his faith. وَقَالُوا لَوْ كُنَّا نَسْمَعُ أَوْ نَعْقِلُ مَا كُنَّا فِي أَصْحَابِ الْجَحِيمِ. If we used our sound reason, we would have been today in this terrible situation. We would have been somewhere else in paradise, not part of أَصْحَابُ الْجَحِيمِ. قوام المرء عقله قوام المرء. The essence, the quintessence of every person is his reason, his intelligence. And therefore, look at the Holy Quran. In almost every chapter, Allah speaks about the people of Ulul Albab, those who possess reason, possess aql. Allah says, this aql is my biggest gift to the humanity. Take it serious. Utilize it. Use it in finding your way in this life. Always Allah speaks good about those. He says the most successful, those who listen to me, those who follow me, are ulul albab, those who possess intellect and possess reason, and they incorporate their reason. And when Allah speaks about knowledge, He does not say only knowledge. He says hikmah. Hikmah. وَمَنْ يُؤْتَى الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوْتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. What does hikmah mean? Hikmah is not only knowledge. Hikmah is knowledge blended with what? With intelligence and wisdom. With understanding. With discernment. Not just knowledge, not any knowledge. A knowledge that intertwines with discernment. This is the meaning of hikmah. Hikmah is to know what to say, when to say, why to say that. If I go to this next door church here and I want to invite them to goodness, I cannot go there and say, oh, Christian people, listen to me, don't drink. This is not hikmah. This is not wisdom. Oh, Christian people, your women have to wear hijab. This is not hikmah. Because they are Christians. If I go there, I have to tell them what are the similarities between our religions. If I want to have a nice approach, intellectual approach, rational approach, then I have to know what to say, how to say, when to say. This is hikmah. This is why God says, when you call for me, incorporate hikmah. أُدْعُوا إِلَىٰ سَبِيلِ رَبِّكَ بِالْحِكْمَةِ. Not only knowledge. Not whatever knowledge you have in your brain, you can throw it at people. No, you have to know what to say. You have to look at people. Are they ready to accept what I am saying or not? Is this speech good for them? It suits them or not? This is hikmah. أُدْعُوا إِلَىٰ سَبِيلِ رَبِّكَ بِالْحِكْمَةِ. Incorporate wisdom when you invite people. Now, my friends, reason should not be separated from religion. Therefore, sometimes you hear some scholars here and there, they speak something which is irrational, does not make sense. Sometimes some of their fatwas, some of their opinions, some of their speeches are mythical. They are fantasies. They are not in line with reality. They are not a practical. Not a practical. Islam is a practical religion. Islam did not come to make my life difficult or miserable. Islam came to make our life easier to practice. If you make it difficult, people cannot practice it. But sometimes we hear some voices from here and there that they speak things that are not in line with rationality. They are actually irrational narrative. I gave some example, and I have many more examples of that. Let's go to Tawheed. I'll give you an example how sometimes when a scholar does not use his brain and he only depends on a text, and that text could be wrong. That text could be wrong. Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salatu wassalam says, اعرفوا منازل شيعتنا على قدر روايتهم عنا وفهمهم منا فإن الرواية تحتاج إلى الدراية وخبر تدريح أفضل أحسن من ألف خبر ترويه. What does that mean? I'll translate that. Imam al-Sadiq says, know the position, the level of our Shia through their understanding of our narrations. So the more better they understand our hadith and our narration, the greater they are. And then he says, فَإِنَّ الرِّوَايَةَ تَحْتَاجُ إِلَى الدِّرَايَةِ. When there is a hadith, riwaya, transmission, story, you have to analyze it, you have to understand it. Don't be like a parrot to repeat it without understanding it. Don't. You have to study it. You have to dissect this riwayah. This is why we have something called ilm al-hadith, ilm al-rijal. Scholars, they spend years and years studying this hadith, whether this hadith makes sense or not. Whether this hadith is in harmony with the Quran, with Ahlulbayt, with the Prophet or not. Even the Prophet himself, he says, if something comes to you that does not make sense, irrational, فَضْرِبُوا بِهِ عَرْضَ الْحَائِطِ. Throw it against the wall. Trash it. We don't say something nonsense. Everything we say is based on logic, is based on reason, is based on the Quran. There is nothing illogical in Ahlul Bayt school. Nothing illogical.